In this video, we're gonna take a look at how to use the accessibility checker from within Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jorson, and let's jump right in. To launch the accessibility checker, I am going to go to the Prepare for Accessibility button and then select Check for Accessibility. Now there's a few different options we can do in here. For one, I can create an accessibility report, which will put an HTML file of the findings onto my desktop. You could also attach the report to this document. Now, in many cases, you will see 31 of 32 categories selected. We want to ensure that we have all of the checkboxes checked amongst all of these categories. Once you ensure you have 32 out of 32, we're checking all pages in the document, we can select Start Checking. This takes us over to the accessibility checker. Now there's two spots that will always remain needs manual check. This is the logical reading order and color contrast. These are forever needs manual check. In this particular document that I'm checking, there appears to be a missing summary, but we can fix that pretty easy, which we will do in another video. But one thing that I wanted to go over is that we cannot rely on the accessibility checker built into Acrobat. It actually does not adhere to any Section 508 standard, WCAG standard, or any aspect of accessibility law or regulations. It's simply built by Acrobat and it's used to spot check certain components of the document. It will not check for accurate alternate text. It does not check for incorrect use of hyperlinks, like if I have full URLs in the document. And it could sometimes pass through information that is just not correct in terms of reading order, what type of tag is used for what, and it really should be used as like a standing point to validate whether or not you have applied all of your other elements correctly. So when I am making a document accessible, I tend to run the accessibility checker from Acrobat last as sort of a final check before I take it into the more rigorous accessibility checks. That concludes today's very brief video on how to use the accessibility checker. If you want to join the new Accessibility Guide community, check out the link in the description below this video. You will gain access to multiple courses that are self-paced and bi-weekly webinars offered by yours truly. And as always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.